So good morning everyone, my name is Isabella Tai and I'm part of group 4. We are going to do analysis of 2021. Other members of this group are Eli and Betty, which will soon come in front of you through the presentation. Okay, so the statement of problem for 2021 will be that they started to file for bankruptcy due to the inability to keep up with the customer base in a very competitive industry. And unfortunately, they also started to take many unethical decisions in an attempt to survive. The statement of purpose of this report will be to determine the position of 2021 by using a SWOT analysis and a borders analysis. We will then evaluate the strategy that they can use to become competitive again. For the report scope, we'll only focus on the unsatisfactory business decision that 2021 took, solutions for it, and we'll make sure to not use any data from companies in different countries. The research strategy will be as follows. First of all, we'll conduct investigations by using credible internet sources, library resources. We then evaluate this information and only introduce what we feel is important in our report. So now we talk about the borders analysis of 2021. So first of all, the borders analysis is a model that has been created by Michael Porter to calculate the position in which any business is, like how they're doing, how the company is doing, and how can they survive in this business world. So the first factor will be the level of rivalry among organizations in the industry. This shows how many industries and, many companies are able to undercut other companies by using their competitive advantage. The environment of 2021 is saturated by ongoing successful retail businesses such as Zara, H&M, Uniqlo, and have developed many competitive advantage on which they focus themselves to be able to flourish in comparison to 2021. For example, Zara uses just-in-time inventory at the place of using just-in-case inventory. By using this method of inventory, they're able to save money because they provide goods just when consumers need. The other factor that we'll introduce will be the potential for entry into the industry. 2021 faces a strong competition due to the high level of entry, meaning that the easier it is for businesses to be able to enter the market, the more competitors there will be. For 2021, research proved that the United States apparel market is expected to grow from $350 billion in 2015 to $385 billion in 2005. In other words, a lot of businesses are just entering the market every day. So another factor that we'll be using the borders analysis will be the power of large customer. The power of large customer is just another word to explain how much consumer can exert pressure on the market. In our case, we observe that the apparel industry is booming with successful businesses and new fashion ventures every day. Those businesses provide different choices, a wide range of choices for all customers. As a result, if 2021 raise the prices, consumers have the power to easily switch from another brand to the next. So the other factor will be the power of large suppliers. The power of large suppliers just shows how strong are suppliers in the market, and the stronger they are, usually the higher prices they will give to companies. In our case, we noticed that 2021 can underpay the workers in Los Angeles because of the strong global shift. They can pressure the contractors who subtract subtract undocumented immigrants willing to sue for a few dollars an hour. So the last factor in the protest analysis will be the trend of substitute product. When many substitutes for fashion clothing exist, this stops 2021 from setting high prices because the product can easily be switched from other products to other products. For example, products that are really close to 2021 products will be Shane, Romwe, Charlotte Russe, which are known to provide the similar product but at very cheap price. As a result, if 2021 want to be able to survive in the market, they have to make sure the product are differentiated in a way. Or they have to make sure they start to endorse the product legally in the same motion as Fashion Nova, which is another of the company turned to.
So I'm going to introduce Forever 21 for us. They were founded by Don Juan Chang and Jin Shuk Chang, Korean immigrants chasing the American dream. They moved to America in about 1981, and in 1984 in Los Angeles, California, they started what was formerly known as Fashion 21, and then by 1990 they changed it to Forever 21, and that opened 100 stores. The business was created because they wanted older people to look 21 and younger people to want to be 21.
Okay. All right, so next we're going to be talking about Forever 21 SWOT analysis. SWOT stands for strengths, weaknesses, questions. They have a variety of clothing in different sections of their clothing. So they have their plus size, they have men, kids, women's, and active lines that they have. They also have a very strong online presence, so their online website is very popular and a lot of people use that to shop there. And it's also very spacious and attractive. They always have very, very big stores. It's always set up kind of the same way. So if you go to a different location, then people usually know where things are. Some of their weaknesses are the numerous legal issues that they have. A big one recently, this past year, was with Ariana Grande, where they used pictures of her and quotes from her lyrics and pictures from her music videos, and then copied her style. And it kind of showed that, or wanted to show that she was endorsing Forever 21, which in fact she never agreed to that, so it kind of caused a lot of legal issues. Another big one is copying designs. They tend to copy a lot of smaller designers because when they try to fight them, Forever 21 is such a big company that they usually lose. The working conditions are also a weakness for them. A lot of previous employees have come out and said that they were underpaid or they had to work through their breaks that were required for them. And bag checks were also a big issue. After they clocked out, they had to get bag checks, and that added sometimes 20 to 30 minutes of time still in the store that they weren't paid for. And they're also more available in the United States. They haven't really expanded that much in Europe or anything, which could cause us a weakness for them. So some of the opportunities for Forever 21 to grow and be more successful would be to come up with their own designs instead of stealing some of the popular ones from other brands, and then opening more stores in other countries, so kind of just expanding more globally. And then some of the threats would be competition with similar stores, so Runway, Shein, Charlotte Russe. They kind of produce all the similar clothing styles for super cheap prices, so there's a lot of competition there. And also just negative perceptions of the company from the legal issues or people, the employees coming out and saying the working conditions aren't okay, so that would be a big threat for them as well. So for the diagnosis, we use the SWOT analysis and the Porter analysis, five forces of Porter's model to find the key management issues with Forever 21. The key ones we found were unethical practices and difficulty to understand the customers, and then we went into the solution and action to solve it.
So some problems they have right now is that some employees are not getting paid, either for their overtime or just not getting paid at all. And then that causes a lack of trust with their, also the employers have a lack of trust with the employees, because we talked about earlier how they have been doing bag checks after clocking out. Just a pretty big one they had going on is being sued by companies or celebrities for identical to similar designs. As you can see here, this is from Ariana Grande's music video, The Seven Rings logo, and then just in the background you can see pretty much the identical seven rings on one of their ads. And also they have a pretty weak consumer relations. So some potential solutions they can have for these problems. So right now they can provide better and more training for the first line managers and upper management so that they may be a better leader and create a more stimulating atmosphere for the employees so they can have just a better time at work and be more efficient. They can also invest in more of their money into their research and development departments so that they don't have to go out and steal ideas from celebrities or different companies. And then for the third solution, they can utilize a customer relationship management system to allow the company to stay connected with your consumers and figure out what the consumer wants. If used properly, the company would save money by not researching or making styles of fashion that their consumers don't want. Example of a customer relationship management system, Apple's been using one over the past probably decade now. They have it where just they'll open up apps or anything you open up, there'll be a survey they'll ask you about. And even after you leave the store, they'll ask, how did that attendant do? As you can see here, they've had a dentist helping someone out. So Forever 21 could use something similar by creating a survey and printing it out on their receipts, so then when they follow the survey link, they can go and they'll be asked about their experience and maybe even other preferences for future products.
A Okay, so now we are going to talk about how to implement CRM, which is customer relationship management. So the first step that Forever One must take will be to build an organizational culture where CRM will be accepted and focused on, meaning they will have to make sure everybody in the business, everybody in the company understand what they are doing that, why they are doing that, and they have to make sure the atmosphere, which is in Forever 21, is a good one, is the one which is focused on customers. And as a result, if it is focused on customers, they know that customers do not like when employees are not treated right. So this will also have a good impact on the conditions of work of employees at Forever 21. The second step should be to appoint a CRM responsible or supervisor. That will be somebody that will be in charge of the project, and this person will have all the necessary information and all the right information about bugs, about quality standard, and you will just provide this information to Forever 21, meaning if anyone has any issue, they can go directly to this person to know how to juggle with the problem. The third step will be to make a mandatory training for all employees. They have to make sure all employees get a regular training on how to use CRM. The fourth step will be to use criteria to measure output, such as number of complaints, customer satisfaction survey. So to kind of understand where they are right now to evaluate their position, they can use the number of complaints of like customers and the customer satisfaction survey. By looking at this, if they see a change, an increase or a decrease, they can know if customer relationship management system is working with the company or not. So the fifth goal would be to set up goals and incentives, meaning they have to set goals like every year when they're using the CRM. It can be like in 2020, they have to make sure 50% of the complaints are being reduced. And when we talk about incentive, they have to make sure they link each of their goals to incentive, meaning if a certain number of the employees have been able to reach a certain level of customer satisfaction, they can give them a bonus or even increase the pay. The sixth action that they should take would be to take corrective actions if necessary, meaning they can decide to do training to some employees that they believe they're not very good with the use of CRM, or in the worst case, they can decide to let some employees go. So what are the advantages of CRM? CRM system will be able to attract new customers into Forever 21, as well as keeping the other ones loyal by giving them what they want and satisfying their wants. The second thing that customer relationship management system will do would be that it is kind of cheap. Even though at first they will have to pay a specific amount of money, in the long term it will be very cheap because it's a cloud-based, and then it doesn't require any type of costly special installation. It is also very scalable and easy to implement, meaning once they will decide to have it, they can just implement it to the system and everything is ready. This chart shows everything that the CRM will be able to give to Forever 21. With the use of these, they will be able to notice a 35% increase in customer satisfaction, a 38% increase in the rate at which they take the decisions, and a 25% increase in their revenue.
All right, so to evaluate our action plan, we want to implement questionnaires and watch more closely to our monthly dollar volume of sales. So with the questionnaires, we will get direct feedback from customers and consumers, and we'll get kind of confirmation on if the store is improving or if it's maybe even doing worse. And we can see then what needs to be improved. So with the questionnaires, we want to give them out before, during, and after the action plan is implemented to really compare and see what the customers really think. And these can be given out either in emails or on the back of receipts, and people can fill them out then. So this also helps long term, because Forever 21 can keep expanding and doing better and keep listening to what customers really want and changing what needs to be done. So some of the questions that we would consider putting on would be if they prefer shopping in store or out of store, what trends they're liking at the moment, and just any constructive criticism for the store in general. And then with the monthly volume dollar sales, we can compare the sales from before and after the action plan is implemented. So we can start to see the changes. If the sales are getting better, then we know that we're doing something right. So to conclude our evaluation of Forever 21's management system, we saw that there are a lot of internal factors or issues like stealing designs, the working conditions that have been causing a lot of issues for Forever 21. But by improving the customer and employee relationship, it will help gain better ratings and respect for the store. So putting the customer needs first and implementing a system that can help them directly communicate with customers will help Forever 21 in the long run and right now. So stronger ties with the employees and management will happen with this action plan, and it will get employees to actually want to work there and enjoy working there, which will then, you know, help them treat customers better and have the customers have a better experience at the store.